So I made a video the other day, and I wanted to remake it and make a better quality one since I just got my new camera. And I wanted to talk about the shoulder and what causes shoulder pain and kind of how to prevent it when it comes to the bench press, when it comes to overhead press, when it comes to for a lot of movements that require pressing. If you notice, a lot of people who do get injured when it comes to shoulder problems has to do with pressing movements. And the reason why is that we tend to be really overused in the front, in the shoulders, in the hips. And a lot of times what happens in the front of the shoulder here is that the humerus, the upper arm, gets basically stuck in front of the capsule. And if you think about kind of how the humerus is set up in the shoulder, I don't know if you can imagine, hopefully I can put up a photo or a picture of anatomy chart, but the humerus basically sits in the socket like this, right? So this is the humeral head. Let's just use my left side right here. Let's pretend this is a scapula or part of the scapula. This is the acromion process, and this is the humerus right here. And then what happens is when our shoulders get rounded, what happens is that our scapula will kind of protract over that humerus, and it kind of closes the space in between. And there are a lot of muscles that run underneath that humeral head. And then over time, if you're pressing heavy weight, moving really fast, pressing overweight, really heavy movements, what's going to end up happening is you're going to end up causing a lot of, you're going to probably cause some impingement or some sort of basically muscles running into one another, if that makes any sense. That's not really an accurate description, but I'm just trying to give you a visual of what happens when you don't have the ideal posture or proper posture or proper mechanical position. Because when you're in the proper mechanical position, which is shoulder blades retraction or good external rotation torque in the shoulder is stable. And when you're kind of loose or your shoulders are protracted, you're in a less stable position. And when you pull yourself out of the least stable position under heavy loads or maximum loads or very high force, what ends up happening, it makes the muscles, it makes the joint move incorrectly or move less optimal and less in a less stable position, which will lead to basically, how can I say this, bad leverage movements. It's kind of thinking like this. You know why? If you ever heard, like, when you pick something up off the ground, it's not a good idea to pick something up heavy when it's far away from you. You want to pick it up close to you, like a deadlift. And the reason why is because you have more mechanical leverage. And if you do a movement with very low mechanical leverage without a good stable position, it puts more torque on the body or more torque on the joint. So kind of one of the things that you can do to kind of help improve position of the shoulder is to do the banded internal rotation stretch, where you put the arm behind the back like so, and you stretch out. I'm not doing it with a band, but I want to show you without a band. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my arm like this. And what I'm doing is I'm trying to internally rotate my arm. And the purpose of this is to help stretch my shoulder. So you can see this here. I'm turning this in. And what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to stretch the muscles that cause the upper arm to internally rotate. Now, we don't want to be in this position, but there are muscles that cause this movement. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to relieve some pressure or stress in that movement pattern. So that way, it makes it easier for us to create external rotation. Because if there's one thing that you do need to know when it comes to shoulder external rotation, having a good open posture, when it comes, like, you know, when you pull your shoulder blades back and you open up your chest, what's important about being in that position is that it allows you to essentially create more torque and be in a much more safer position to prevent risk of shoulder irritation. And what you're trying to do is that when you stretch that internal rotator, when it's tight, it makes it easier for you to create more torque. So with the band right here, I'm going to use this, my squat rack. And then all I'm going to do is going to take the band here. Hopefully you can see this. Pull my arm in my shoulder like this and then lean forward. So that way it pulls the humerus, the upper arm, into the socket much better. And then I'm going to pull my arm behind my back. And what this does, it kind of, not only does it help improve a stretch internal rotation of the internal rotators, and what it does, it helps put the shoulder in the ideal position. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to mobilize the position of restriction, and we're trying to mobilize a good position. Because all we're trying to do is we're trying to create better internal rotation and external rotation. Because then what happens if you don't have good internal rotation, when you bring the bar down, because remember, when your arm goes down to a bench, your humerus, upper arm, is turning in. Okay, so you come down, it's turning in. Now, if you're not able to get good internal rotation, you have no choice but for your shoulders to roll forward because you can't get this internal rotation because this upper arm won't internally rotate properly because of tight internal rotators like your subscapularis. Also keep in mind that your chest and your lats, because they insert pretty much on the inside of the arm here, the humeral head, humerus, the upper arm, when they get really tight, they really force the shoulders to come in and they rotate. So that's definitely one of the better stretches. Another thing that you can do to kind of help mitigate and kind of improve the movement of the shoulders is that you can try to do a smash. And this is using this mobility ball, which I showed you before. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press it on my shoulder like this and make little circles. So I'm trying to improve the way the shoulder moves. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this ball, I'm going to press it against my shoulder, like so. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create pressure on the front of the delt. And what this will, you should feel some, maybe some mild tenderness. And what this will do is allow the humerus to kind of slide and glide underneath that scapula better. It allows the muscle, it encourages blood flow. It also encourages the muscles to move much more in a much more smoother fashion. Because what happens is the muscles gets really sticky. They kind of, because remember, muscles are surrounded in a fascia, kind of like a film. And sometimes that fascia, because of tight musculature and overuse of certain movement patterns, being sitting in a car, commuting, sitting in front of a desk, in front of a computer, benching too much, doing a lot of front movements, we end up overusing the front of our shoulders and it gets really junky. And what happens is those tissues end up kind of getting stuck together underneath the fascia. And what you're trying to do by doing this is you're trying to basically separate the muscles so they move a little bit more independently. Now that's not exactly how it works scientifically, but that's basically what you're trying to do. You're trying to improve fluidity of the muscle tissue so that you have better movement, and that way you can minimize essentially things running into each other, stop things from running into each other. That's kind of basically what causes people. I was on one of Johnny Candido's videos. There was a guy who made a comment about his hip bothering him, and it's a similar idea. When the hip, he'll see, every time he squats really low, he'll get a hip and like a hip pain. And I'm not exactly sure what his exact problem is, but I have a similar hip pain or hip problem, which he described. And essentially what's happening is something is running in. And the hip, it can be a little bit different because it's a much bigger joint, bigger muscle groupings. So sometimes the upper thigh bone will run into the acetabulum or the socket. It's because, you know, remember, the shoulder is very similar to the hip. And what ends up happening is that hip can basically jack up. Can basically run out of space in the front, because as the muscle flexes up, you run out of space here. And it's sort of hard to explain, but I hope you got the idea. Comment below if you'd like to hear more of these videos, because I love talking about this stuff. And thanks for watching.